Gloria Campbell. Gloria, a Métis woman born and raised in Duck Bay, to Nora Muzimi and Louis Janai. Gloria began her teaching career in 1978 and retired in 2009 from the Duck Bay School. While raising three beautiful daughters, Maxine, Lynn, and Lindsay, Gloria is a grandmother to 12 grandchildren and five great-grandchildren. Miss Gloria taught Soto in the school and made up her own songs and chants to teach to the children at school and at home. Miss Gloria volunteers in the community, helping with funerals, singing in the choir, assisting the priest, and odds and ends as required. In her spare time, Miss Gloria enjoys helping her sisters, picking plants and roots, driving the sisters to their destinations, and most importantly, to the blueberry fields where they pick as a family. Miss Gloria can always be found praying and happily visiting with her grandchildren.
My name is Gloria Campbell. I come from Duck Bay, Manitoba. I am a retired teacher of 31 years. I come from a family, amazing family of 13 children, which I'm feel very blessed and very fortunate to come from a family of 13 children. Very, very amazing. Okay, I'm doing a number song. I'm teaching numbers from 1 to 10 in this song, in Soto. But it's also in English. It translates it to English, what I'm singing about. I included animals there. But before this, in school, when I was a teacher, I introduced the animals first, like how many rabbits, how many squirrels, how many beavers, how many ducks, and I used different animals. But mostly it's teaching about numbers, because it repeats Pejik is one, like Pejik is in Soto, and then one in English, so it's repetitive again. This one goes to a chant that I picked. We did all the animals, I pre-taught the animals before then. So this way, they were just repeating these, and that's how they learn the numbers. And they also learn the animals. So it's good for both numbers, number song with animals, as I called it. When I was teaching the students, they tap their laps, because it goes with it, like it's like a chant. So I'll just tap my lap here. But okay. Pejik is one, Pejik is one, Pejik wapos, Pejik is one. One rabbit. Nish is two, Nish is two, Nishachitamok, Nish is two. Two squirrels. Nis was three, Niswe amikok, Niswe is three. Three beavers. Niwin is four, Niwin is four, Niwin shishipak, Niwin is four. Four ducks. Nanan is five, Nanan is five, Nanan poshak, Nanan is five. Five cats. Gotoswe is six, Gotoswe is six, Gotoswe animoshak, Gotoswe is six. Six dogs. Ninshaswe is seven, Ninshaswe is seven, Ninshaswe kukushak, Ninshaswe is seven. Seven pigs. Ninshaswe is eight, Ninshaswe is eight, Ninshaswe pshikyuk, Ninshaswe is eight. Eight cows. Shangaswe is nine, Shangaswe is nine, Shangaswe mstatimok, Shangaswe is nine. Nine horses. Metaswe is ten, Metaswe is ten, Metaswe mozok, Metaswe is ten. Pejik is one, Pejik is one, Pejik wapos, Pejik is one. One rabbit. Nish is two, Nish is two, Nishachitamok, Nish is two. Two squirrels. Niswe is three, Niswe is three, Niswe amikok, Niswe is three. Three beavers. Niwin is four, Niwin is four, Niwin shishipak, Niwin is four. Four ducks. Nanan is five, Nanan is five, Nanan poshak, Nanan is five. Five cats. six dogs. Seven pigs. Eight cows. Shanga swiss nine horses. Metaswiss ten. Metaswiss ten. Peshik is one. Nishes two. Nishes two. Nis was three. Nis was three. Nis was three. Nee when is four. Nee when is four. Nee when is four. Nee when is four. Naan is five. Naan is five. Naan is five. Gotoswe six. Gotoswe animushak. Gotoswe six. Nishoswe seven. Nishoswe seven. Nishoswe eight. Shanga swiss nine. Shanga swiss nine. Shanga swiss nine. Metaswiss ten. Metaswiss ten. Metaswiss ten. Metaswiss ten. Metaswiss ten. Talk about respect, how I was taught respect from my parents. My parents were very, very strong and hardworking, and they taught us many things, especially the one thing that I carry my life today. And I'm so very proud to say that they taught me respect. The most important thing there is to live is to carry that respect all through your life. It's very, very amazing. And very good to have that, to carry that all through the years. My parents were very a close-knit family as we did things together, everything together. We ate together, we played together, all my siblings. We always stayed together, we worked together. They taught us how to work when we were very young. We had to work, us too. So they gave us the working ethics. That's why I became a teacher too, because they showed us how to work hard and make a living for ourselves. So I am very blessed and honored to talk about my parents. Their names were Nora Janai and Louis Janai, Mr. and Mrs. Louis Janai. I'm very proud of them to have taught me these lessons, the teachings of respect. The first thing they taught us was to respect elders, people. Our uncles, our aunts, our cousins. We have to respect them and have an unconditional love for them. And They also taught us to respect animals, as the animals also gave us the gifts to make a living too, because my dad was a trapper and a hunter. So the Creator blessed him in that way, blessed us that way, for him to teach us about the animals, that in return helped us. And we also respected property. They always taught us about respecting other people's property. Do not go touch anybody's property. That's not yours. You don't go there. You don't touch them. You don't steal from them. And I'll tell you how they taught us these three things that stuck with us all our lives. And I'm still using the respect today, which I am very proud of. So the first, when the elders came to my house, there was lots of us in the house. So as soon as that elder came in, my mom and them offered them to sit down, give them tea or offer them food, whatever they had, if they could. And then we had to go, we went outside. We respected them so much. We didn't even walk by them, close by them. But we also talked to them because they were elders. We talked to them and they also told us stories. Like sometimes they would take turns. My dad would tell us and then the other elder would tell us the stories. So we learned to respect them in that way. We respected the elders so much that we respected our parents, number one parents, to listen to them. When my mom and dad talked, we listened right away because we respected them so much. And they also taught us to respect uncles and aunties, our cousins, and our siblings. If I had an older sister and an older brother, we had to listen and we had to respect them. We could not talk back to them. We respected them. And that was a good way because we still respect each other now. When there was 13 of us, we still keep on, we never argue. We talk to each other. We don't argue because we respect each other. And then to respect other people too, that's how we respect other people. And then they taught us how to respect animals. And my dad, he was a hunter, so he got a lot of meat. He had to get, because there was lots of us to feed, to raise all of us. There was 13 of us in the family. So he went, if he got meat, if he put it on the table, or he put it sometimes, because it was a big animal, on the floor, but he'd put something under a tarp. We couldn't walk by it. He said, don't even walk by that meat. Don't step over that meat. We had to respect that meat because he said Creator gave us that meat to eat, to feed us, and to share. He also shared it with the other people in the community, my dad, because some of them wanted some meat, moose meat or jumper meat or whatever kind of meat he got. He also liked to share it. That's how we learned how to respect the animals. He said you can't hurt an animal too, like for nothing. Like if you had a dog or a cat, so you can't. You got to treat them good. He said you got to treat animals good too, because Creator put them here for us too, for a reason. He said, so we respected the animals too, and then the property. In the summertime in May, we were going to go working. He would take us out of school by the middle of June. We'd go pulp cutting. And then all of us would work, all of us. Well, even if we were 7, 8 years old, we were all working, either taking lunch for them, or we'd peel the logs for pulp cutting. His men would work for him, as my brothers, there was lots of us. And then we'd pick blueberries after that. We'd come back. We were away about 3 months in the summer. But when we were gone, this is the respect that we learned for property. We didn't even board up our house. That's how much the people respected a long time ago. We didn't even have a lock on our door. That people did not touch anything. They did not come, because them too, they had the same respect. They did not lock. You just leave your house like that without locking it. Sometimes they would use a string, but a string is, you can open a string. But they had so much respect. I guess they were taught respect them too, to respect everybody, to respect their property, animals, people. And that's all you need in life, to respect those things. Then you have everything in your life. You have everything. You could go on your life And it depends on just situations, though, at times now, nowadays. But most of all, to be kind and to be helpful if you can, if you're able to in your life, and be compassionate. The most thing is to be compassionate, because you'll feel sorry for people. You're with people. And that's how you be kind to them as much as you can. And that's good respect, all the things that they taught us. All the teachings were very good, and I still use them today. And I thank my parents, for my beautiful parents, my strong parents, for teaching me. Gloria Dishnikas, I she busy being don't say. Me day, the mama's gone papa, me think I am in. You saw me, the menabitin papa to con the mama gay, kikchanuk yuk, chopi ginguang. Metasimin on swing it a shaman. Yang jauh sami ni men, kena gego ni itu tamin, ay, tak suka mamun yang tapita, jauh cipta men dote men, aku cing, kena tapita jauh tamin men, tapita gego ni itu tamin, mamun yang tapita gay, jiwis sene men, aku cing gak nak kimen, kena mamawin nak kimen. You are we cheat them in Kinagago, because you can't among an inch say, Baba to the mamma chickenama guang, an inchish manacha talk, canan snapek. Me got I ing canama gonank chan snapek, you much canama gonan mean now what need I me get cheek cheat any mang, coyak chito tong, chay. Ich gebe bin die Gott und dann mir go song gi saga bin kan in mang jo gi puske ko puske ma che musang ma pesho but dann ko shungi ka no na na gi sa so ka ko nan ge wi no ab che de mama gi te ko papa ki chano ki ok ke na ma go an ke ne ge go ab che i ne men dan we ge i ke na ma go an ke ne ge go mi e ko nda pa chitun Kedin me tu taman tasku gayi no kagai kagi baca mana cewat dan snapen juga wensian juga pakana yo tapat cikanan kena mini kedama kena koi cito taman cun juga nap mang ike dan snapek mien yo netam kagi kedama guang minit ay cun snapek mien mawan cik cina ni mang Koi cito tong, koi cikan unang. Cikgu awen siak menon bapa, ayat tuan cikgu tapita. Anshna ni po cahsha mikuang ni po apa no siak. Mie gayi. Mie gik kenama gunan. Kira gayu. Cikgu ayat menon kenama gunan bapa, awen siak cemana cang. Ayat ka. Peanut mami ega puske pastong shgoi chei ega suku machi shanga pinch anishna mani chmani togi mini konani niketa che chimichiang mi piko chei koi piko ega koi kai piko koi chito tong mus ega chikata kana yang ega chitako kana ek abche che Cik Cina dah mek, kasih kita sama gunan, mau je, sih kau cai, cina nak kemain mana itu, misi kau ini, lebih ni kau ingin je, awen siak ke, sih, ayer eka sih kita mai tak kita awen siak, tak kau ni masih kemar posak, eka sih kau kata dia tak kita, awen siak cuma nak dia tak, ayer mana? Apa cikgu dan perkara yang apa cikgu dan kita kau ikut kau macam ke cikgu kau gigi muti ek kau macam itu tapenamek kan kan ikhaya cito taman Ab jo chamanat ya ta kan snapek ai ega ya chito taman kan minus ses nunya ya chiki motien jai chiku ga ki motte matok kego ega sa kuchen pa chi kautok achi chiku ga wi cha tok na watch pich kego chiku ga to tam chiku ga to tok kego chiku ga tap na ma tok mi chiku mi ningi kina ma ko na na pichen me na ta mi ne gi kina ma ko an kina kego ai chimi da kan op mang an snapek awan siak shugo ka pet chikan no ye pakar ta pa chikanan mi ab chini menen tam kapi wen ta pat tun ko ka mat sian chiko ko kinam bo kok da pe no chi mak ka gi pe kinam bo kok sa ko kinam bo mi go ke wi no da pe no chi mak go da ko da ko pe ni chak na chiko yak nusak apa sih jauh ni mak, mi kau yak kene gego mi mana? Si mi kau ech, kena kan tu tamak, apa sih nung kau mana entah degi pisan, apa sih mana entah aku tu eh, awak entah aku tu, awak ni sekolah dah ni kau tunggu pakai kita ni ketiket, but mi wega ge kan itak ka chige nan ko tnge ko kan dikat si ko yak mi kan got na touch mi shigo I'd like to thank everyone for listening to my stories and my songs. I am so honored to be here today to do that, and I hope you enjoy them. Chimi gwech mi noga gop min see you again soon. Okay, mi gwech.